first. Steve, go ahead.
Hey, Hernan, good to see you, man.
Good to see you. How are you?
What is your what's your expectations now with the season starting? Your expectation for the first part of the season, which you have mentioned might take a little time to get into the rhythm, and your expectation for the long term.
I repeat, I'm gonna give you the same answer, and sorry for that. That I was giving to all your colleagues, that my expectation for the first season is to have a new identity and a new style of play. And I hope that you guys can already see that in 2 days.
And what, in terms of this very first game, you spoke last week or 2 weeks ago about the fitness and the ability to play up to the level of your system. Where do you think you are right now?
The same as we were 2 weeks ago. The same. Not being able to play that style of play for 90 minutes and having to use probably the five replacements we have to get a boost of energy at the end of the game.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. We'll go to Moises Linares next. Moises, go ahead.
Hernán, ¿cómo estás? Un fuerte abrazo. Ya listo para la temporada, me imagino. Las sensaciones previas del primer partido, ¿cuáles son?
Las mejores, con mucho entusiasmo. Luego de un largo break, todos estamos con muchas ganas de que comience el campeonato, de que se empiece a jugar por los puntos, poder recibir nuevamente fans. Y poder jugar el primer partido de local es algo hermoso. Lo estuvimos esperando por mucho tiempo, así que con las mejores sensaciones.
Steve reportaba, I'm gonna give Steve some credit here, sobre Andy Nahar y la incorporación de este jugador que tiene un pasado aquí, creo que está a tu lado, me imagino. Tiene un pasado aquí en Washington DC, su familia está acá, la afición lo conoce, tú jugaste contra él, fuiste técnico contra él. ¿Qué significa tener un jugador como él, centroamericano, en este equipo?
Él estuvo entrenando con nosotros, haciendo el preseason, y eso es todo. Más no te puedo decir. Así que, si ustedes saben más que yo, por favor coméntenme qué es lo que saben, porque lo
Bueno,
único.
se reporta que se incorpora al equipo. No sé si es oficial, simplemente te lo pregunto. Bueno, no sé si no lo es, pero ¿qué fue lo que viste de Andy durante las 6 semanas? Si te puedo preguntar.
Sí, eso sí. Un Andy muy motivado, un Andy intentando ponerse bien desde lo físico, sabiendo de todas las dificultades que tuvo para tener continuidad en los últimos años. Y ese fue el objetivo. Nosotros conocemos de las cualidades de Andy, lo conozco muy bien de su paso por Anderlecht, y aquí en DC United también lo conoce muy bien. Así que lo que queríamos era verlo durante la pretemporada. Y bueno, y ojalá que él se pueda sumar al grupo, pero todavía no es oficial y todavía no está en la página del DC United, así que no puedo decir más que eso.
Gracias, Hernán.
De nada.
We'll go to Jason Anderson next. Jason, go ahead.
Hi, Hernán. Thank you for speaking with us today. Hope you're doing well.
I'm doing well, Jason. How are you doing?
I'm all right. I'm doing all right. Busy, but okay. I guess my first question is, you've already played NYCFC this year, which is a strange situation going into the first game. But I'm sure between that game and watching them play last year quite a bit, you've probably picked up on some pretty distinct impressions with them. They haven't really undergone too many changes on their roster, at least. What are your thoughts on them as an opponent, going into this one?
They have a very good team, a very technical team who likes to play like most of the city group clubs try to play, ball over the ground based on ball possession, very young talented players. They made a few good transfers on the midfield and the forward, a team who's gonna be for sure in the top five, top four, and they will play playoffs. So, nothing that you didn't know, I guess.
Maybe. I assume you have a better impression than I do of them. My second question, I know you've gotten Nigel and Giovanni in. They've gotten through the visa process and the quarantine. How far along are they in terms of possibly being able to participate in this game?
Nigel, he was playing in Bulgaria before he came here. So he seems fine. This week was his first week with the group, so we will take it easy with him. Bolivar is not ready. We'll take a couple of months. So we won't count on him for the next weeks.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Jason. We'll go to Andy from the Washington Times next. Andy, go ahead.
Hey, Aaron, thanks for your time this afternoon.
Thank you.
Just for you, out of your first competitive fixture as DC United's manager, what's that kind of the excitement level for you?
Can you repeat the question, please?
Yeah. Ahead of your first competitive match, the first one that actually counts for DC United, how much excitement do you feel?
A lot. A new competition, a new league, new rules. I'm very excited and I'm looking forward. Everyone is looking forward to this new season, and I can't wait. I really can't wait.
You think you get much sleep on Friday night, or it's gonna be up?
No, I'm a good sleeper. I can sleep well, and I have long days at work. So when the night comes, I can always sleep well. So that won't be a problem. But of course, I will wake up on Saturday morning excited to come to the Audi Field and to meet again our fans and try to have a good opening game.
Thank you.
We'll go to Mario Amaya next. Mario, go ahead.
Hola, Hernán. Buenas tardes. Solo quiero preguntar, en lo personal, ¿cómo te sientes a casi a 48 horas de que comience la temporada y cómo te sientes en lo personal de debutar como entrenador en un partido oficial del DC United y en la MLS?
Se siente muy bien, Mario, muy bien. Se siente especial, se siente como si un nuevo capítulo en mi vida estuviera comenzando, lleno de energía, lleno de positivismo y vamos United.
We'll go back to Steve Goff. Steve, go ahead.
Hernan, the supporters here in Washington also always have high expectations, high hopes for the team. What is your message to the supporters as this new era begins this weekend?
Well, coming from a season where the team ended up before last, I can imagine that the supporters wants to do better than last season and wants to get entertainment. And that's what we're going to try to give, not only to the DC United fans, but to the whole league. That little by little, also neutral supporters and neutral fans likes to watch our games. And we can give that style of play that makes the fans pay for a ticket to come and watch us. That's the goal, and that's what we're going to try to give on Saturday. We know that the result is very important, but it's a process. I already talked about that. When you come to replace a coach after 10 years, you need some time, you know. You can't change everything in 6-7 weeks. Rome wasn't built in a couple of weeks, so it will take some time, and it will be good. I'm very positive that we're gonna achieve our goals, and we will try to entertain the fans. That's our goal.
We'll take a few more questions. We'll go to Alonso Contreras next. Alonso, go ahead.
Hey, ¿qué tal? Profesor, ¿cómo está? Hace la semana pasada, en la otra conferencia, me comentaba que Jordi Reina estaba lesionado. ¿Cómo sigue su evolución en esta lesión? Gracias.
Recuperándose, lesionado aún, como muchos otros en nuestro equipo, lamentablemente.
We will go to Jorge Vargas next. Jorge, go ahead.
terminas. ¿Qué tal, Hernán?
¿Qué tal?
Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto.
Quería hacerle, la primera pregunta que quería hacerle era con respecto a Edison Flores. ¿Cuál es su expectativa con Edison Flores en esta nueva temporada? Y bueno, quería preguntarle también, para la gente que no conoce mucho su juego, ¿cuánto de su juego como profesional tiene o va a tener este DC United? Muchas gracias.
Esperemos que mucho. Yo era un jugador creativo, me gustaba entretener a los fans y siempre me gustó el fútbol ofensivo. Una vez que me convertí en entrenador, entendí que hay que tener un equilibrio, como todo en la vida, y el equipo tiene que saber qué hacer cuando tiene la pelota, pero también cuando no la tiene. Así que esperemos haya cosas interesantes para el público desde la parte ofensiva, pero también me gusta mucho el orden táctico y la disciplina defensiva. Y sobre Eddie, bueno, las mejores expectativas. Eddie tuvo una buena pretemporada, trabajó muy bien, se está poniendo cada día mejor desde lo físico y el equipo lo tiene que ayudar. Cuando uno juega en un equipo que funciona y en un equipo donde cada uno sabe qué hacer, luego individualmente todos comienzan a jugar mejor, así que va a ser también un proceso para él. Estoy muy contento con él y con todos los chicos, la verdad que trabajaron muy bien y esperemos que Eddie pueda tener una mejor temporada que la anterior, y no solo Eddie, que todos los chicos puedan divertirse y puedan tener un buen año, un año con mucha salud y buen fútbol.
We'll do one more question. We'll go to John Hoffman. John.
Hi, Hernan. Thanks for taking the time. This is sort of building off of Jason's question. I think a lot of the selection choices that you would have to make are somewhat made for you by injury and players available. The forward position is interesting to a lot of the fans because it's you're dealing with players who are on international duty, who just transferred in the case of Roberta. How comfortable do you feel with your options up front as you start the year and sort of the depth that you have in that position?
In which position?
Forward, and the nine.
I feel pretty comfortable. I think I have options. Of course, I would like to have Nigel 4 weeks ago. And I would like to have all the forwards already for 2-3 months, so I can train with them much more and teach them how I want them to move a lot more. But no, I have options. I have options. So, of course, I would like to have more, and the more fit players that you have in your roster, the more options you can have. But slowly, let's hope everyone is getting fit and is coming back and is available to play. And the more options I have, the more competitivity in the group. The more you have to fight for your position in the first 11, and we make everyone better. So let's hope that's happening soon and that each week we can recover an extra player and have more competitivity in our roster.
Coach, thank you. That's it. Appreciate it.
Okay. Thank you, guys. See you on Saturday.